Good afternoon, children. This is standard 4.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
This is standard. Close your camera, Kirti. Close your camera, beta. Kirti, close your camera. Okay. This is standard 4 English. Today we'll start with a new lesson, that is lesson 4. Before that, I want to show you a picture. Sony, close your camera, beta. Okay. Now look at this picture. Look at this picture. What do you see in this picture here?
The insects.
Insects. There are all different kinds of insects. There are all different kinds of insects. Okay, these are all different kinds of insects. What are insects? What are insects? What are insects? I am asking you the question. Kirti, can you tell me what are insects? They are tiny creatures. Okay? What are insects? Insects are nothing but tiny creatures. Okay, name some insects. Name some insects.
Butterfly.
Okay. So you are aware, you people are aware about what are insects and some names of some insects. How do insects help us? How do insects help us? How do insects help us? Can anyone?
Ma'am, different kinds of insects help different kinds. Like honeybee gives us honey.
Very good. Then, Sony, close your camera, I said. Okay, only honeybee gives us honey. There are no other insects which helps us. There are many kinds of insects. They help us in many different ways. We only don't have time to look at them, or we don't have time to study them. There are many insects on earth. They help us in many different ways. There are insects who are working very hard. Children, what is work? What is work? What is called as work? What is work? Can anyone tell me? What is work?
Ma'am, something we do is called work.
Something which we do. Something where we apply our physical force, a physical energy, it is called as work. All have understood what is work? All know now what is work? All know what is work? What is hard work then? What is hard work? If you say something which we do, something in which we apply our physical energy or force is called as work. Then what is hard work? Then what is hard work?
Something we do very hard.
What is hard work? What is hard work then?
Ma'am, we do very good. Energy.
Work.
is called hard work.
For every work you have to put energy. For every work you have to put energy. So that is work. What is hard work? What is hard work?
When we put up the maximum capacity, it is known as hard work.
When we put our maximum capacity, she means to say, when we are assigned with some work, we should develop interest, we should take interest, and we should try to complete the given work very sincerely, not unwillingly or not half-heartedly. If a target is given to you, if a work is given, you have to do it with full dedication. You have to do it with full interest. Now, for example, teacher gives you all homework. Maybe in the beginning of the lesson or in the middle of the lesson or at the end of the lesson, teacher gives you homework. How many of you do it wholeheartedly? How many of you, teacher tells you, read this lesson, tomorrow I will ask you questions. Out of 40 children, hardly 4-5 will read the lesson. Others all, they will not even touch the book, they will not even open the book or page. You can't call that as hard work. Assignments are given, projects are given, and particular date is given to complete it and submit. Out of 40 children, 7-8 children only will complete the assignment or project and they will submit on the due date. Others will just let it go. So you can't call that as hard work. Hard work is something which you plan and you decide and you complete that task and you prove that you can do better work. When people appreciate your work, when people appreciate your dedication, that is called as hard work. How do we get honey? How do we get honey? We get honey from honeybees. Is it so easy to make honey? Is it so easy to make honey? No, it is very difficult. Can I and you make honey? Can I and you make honey? No, we cannot. We cannot make honey because we are not honeybee. Only a honeybee can collect nectar or the sweet juice from flower and they will prepare the honey. And that takes, it is a procedure and even that takes a lot of time. So for all this, you need hard work. And ultimately you get a satisfaction and you feel happy for completing the task. How do insects help the farmers? How do insects help the farmers? Because insects are called as the farmer's friends. The insects are called as the farmer's friends. Some of the insects, not all. Some of the insects are called as farmers. How do they help them? How do insects help the farmers?
Ma'am, because to improve the quality of soil.
Yes. And who does that? The earthworm. The earthworm improves the fertility of the soil. The earthworm improves the fertility of the soil. And there are many insects, they eat away the other insects which destroys the crops. There are many insects which destroys or eats up the other insects which destroys the crops. That is why such insects are called as the farmer's insects. Now, look at this picture. Yes? Look at this picture. What comes to your mind? What comes to your mind?
And we can see insects.
You can see insects, but see the surrounding there. Yes. Yes. The insects are planning for a party. The insects are planning for a party. Now, what kind of party are they going to have? What kind of a party are they going to have? Are they going to sing and dance? Are they going to sing and dance? Yes. They will sing and dance. Are they going to have? Are they going to have some food, snacks and food and all? Yes. This is insect party, not people's party. It is insects party. Now, in this lesson, that is lesson 4, the Pulka Dot Lady. Now, who is called as the Pulka Dot Lady? Who is called as
Ladybird?
Why do we call the ladybird as the Pulka Dot Lady? Why do we call it as the Pulka Dot Lady? We call it as the Pulka Dot Lady because it has got beautiful polka dots on its body. It's red in color. The insect, the ladybird, is red in color and it has got black polka dots on its back, on its body. That is why it is called as the Pulka Dot Lady. It is called as the Pulka Dot Lady. So today in this chapter, the Pulka Dot Lady, we will see what is happening during the party, or who is arranging the party, or why is the party being arranged, who are the other members who are going to join in this party, that is the other members, the other insects, and what discussion will take place, and how are they going to celebrate the party. Lesson 4, the Pulka Dot Lady. So here we are going to discuss about the lady bird. Mrs. Ladybird is invited to a party. Mrs. Ladybird is invited to a party. So now we have to read the story to find out how she manages to go to the party. Why there is a question? Read the story to find out how she manages to go to the party. Why is this question? Because the ladybird is a very hard worker, hard working insect. So he doesn't find time for himself. And usually when we go for a party or when we go to visit somebody, we dress up properly. We dress properly, we wear good clothes, we brush our hair properly, and then we see that we look little smarter or we look little more beautiful, and then we go. But in the story, the ladybird has been invited by her friends for a party, but she is hesitant to go. She is hesitating to go there. What is the reason why she is hesitating to go? We will know only when we read further. Mrs. Ladybird is invited to a party. So the ladybird, Mrs. Ladybird, is invited to a party. Mrs. Ladybird is a hard worker. She is a dedicated worker. She is a hard worker. No one in the Pleasant Valley helps farmer green more than she does. So she is the farmer's best friend. Who is that? It is none other than the ladybird, Mrs. Ladybird. It is mentioned here, Mrs. Ladybird is a hard worker. Mrs. Ladybird is a hard worker. No one in the Pleasant Valley helps Farmer Green more than she does. So she helps Farmer Green, and no one else helps as much as she helps. So Mrs. Ladybird, she is the farmer's friend. She helps the farmer. Now how does she help the farmer? She keeps the trees in the orchard free from insects. She keeps the trees in the orchard free from insects. Her constant hard work means that she eats many of the farmer's enemies. Now, who are the farmer's enemies? Farmer's enemies are the other insects that spoils the crop or destroys the crops. So, she keeps the trees in the orchard. Now, what is an orchard? Orchard is a place where a same kind of plantation takes place. A same kind of trees are grown in hundreds and thousands. Suppose if they are planted orange there, you will get all the orange trees. If they are planted apples, you will find all the apple trees. If they are planted bananas, you will find all the banana plants. So such place or such farm is called as an orchard. So the ladybird, what she does? She keeps the trees in the orchard free from insects. Her constant hard work means that she eats many of the farmer's enemies. So she's continuously working in the orchard, continuously keeping a watch on the insects who will come and destroy the crops. And then she eats the farmer's enemy, those who destroy the crops or the yield. Freddy Firefly. There's another insect. We usually call it as the firefly. You get to see this in the night time. You get to see this in the night time. They glow. When they move out in the night, they glow. And you feel they give out light. So the name of the firefly is Freddy. Freddy Firefly wastes too much of his time dancing at night. You can see that on page number 31. Yes? To the left side it is given, where the firefly is glowing. Freddy Firefly wastes too much of his time dancing at night. It is not only the firefly, it is many among us, many of our students. We don't value time. They waste time like anything. Things are not done at that proper time. They don't follow the timetable. They don't know time management. So, Freddy Firefly is wasting a lot of time only dancing at night. Buster Bumblebee. Now there's a one another insect called as bumblebee. One more insect called as bumblebee. And that is Buster. Name of the bumblebee is Buster. Buster, bumblebee, the queen's son, is a useless idler dressed in black velvet and gold. So here there is comparison of insects. The firefly wastes all the time singing and dancing in the night, and Buster, the bumblebee, the queen's son, is an useless idler, idle, fit for nothing, not doing anything, dressed in black, velvet and gold. What do they see in this gaudy creature? What do they see in this gaudy creature? Bitsy butterfly is always flitting from flower to flower, followed by her admirers. If you see a butterfly, you will find the butterfly is never stable in one place, not even a second. They just keep jumping or flying from one flower to another. Why do they do that? They do that because they have to collect the nectar from the flower. They have to collect the nectar from the flower so that they take out the juice and they enjoy the juice, because the nectar from flowers are sweet. What do they see in this gaudy creature? Bitsy butterfly is always flitting from flower to flower, followed by her admirers. If you see butterflies, they have got colorful wings, dotted wings, different in sizes, from the tiny to the biggest. Butterflies look very cute and very beautiful with their beautiful designs on their wings. Bitsy butterfly stops Mrs. Ladybird on her way. So Bitsy butterfly, she goes to visit Ladybird and she stops Ladybird on her way. Bitsy butterfly stops Mrs. Ladybird on her way. She invites her to her party and asks if she could come. So Bitsy butterfly stops Mrs. Ladybird and invites her to join her party. If I come, I'll just drop in for a few minutes as I have work tomorrow. I have no time to flitter away. So when Bitsy butterfly invites Ladybird, the Ladybird replies for the invitation. What does she say? If I come, I'll just drop in for a few minutes as I have work tomorrow. I have no time to flitter away. So the Ladybird is telling, if I have to come for your party, I will not spend more time because I have lot of work for tomorrow. I have to plan work for tomorrow. I have to plan things for tomorrow. So if I come, I will spend only few moments, little few time, some time with you all, and then I'll get back to my work. I can't waste time. Time is very precious for me. I can't waste time. She says, and she goes back to her house. She accepts the invitation, but she doesn't promise that she will stay till the last and she tells her that she will only spend some time in the party, and she goes back to her own house. Oh no, I work all day and now I am covered in dust. How will I go to Bitsy's party? So the ladybird goes home and sees her face in the reflection in the mirror. And she's thinking, she says, oh no, I work all day. I work all day and now I am covered in dust. How will I go to Bitsy's party? Please mute your system. Tigri, mute your system. So the ladybird is looking in the mirror and she's talking to herself. I work the whole day and I am covered in dust. And I don't look beautiful. I don't look clean. Because whole day I am working, I don't give time for myself. How can I go with this kind of this thing to Bitsy's party? So children, whether it is animal or whether it is insect or whether it is human being, we have to work. We have to learn to work hard. We cannot be lazy. We cannot just admire nature. We just cannot eat and sleep. We just cannot be idle. To get something, you have to struggle. To gain something, you have to take pain. Without struggling, without taking pain, you will not get anything. So to become a successful man, a successful person in life, we have to struggle. There's a beautiful story about a spider. It's a beautiful proverb. Try and try till you succeed. There's a beautiful story about a spider who tries to climb up. He falls again and again, but he never loses hope. He keeps trying, and in the end, he reaches his destination. So children, this is an example for us. This is an example for us that we should never stop working hard. Things don't come easily in our hands. Our parents, they go out and they struggle only so that they can provide us with all the requirements. They struggle in the house, they struggle in the office, then only they can fulfill our demands. So we have to put in habit, put in practice from now. Even we have to improve, we have to work hard. We cannot, the assignment, the project, the homework, what teachers give you, you have to do it on time. Then only you'll be